Hello, Bethany family. Can you believe it is the first Friday of August already? That was quite a storm that we came through, and I know that a number of you lost power. Hopefully, if you aren't up and running now, you will be very, very soon. The church also lost power for 2 days due to a large tree that came down in our neighborhood, taking down a number of wires with it. Fortunately, we are up and going again. And we just lost one small tree in the parking lot and one piece of siding up on the steeple that's going to have to change. So we were very, very fortunate for that. Then an important update about the sewer system. The excavation is complete and the parts are here. So weather cooperating, they will begin working on it next Thursday, August the 13th, because all water must be turned off and absolutely no use of facilities at the church that day, the church will be closed on Thursday, August the 13th. We want to thank everybody that has worked so hard on this, Peter Simmons and Greg Levinson and all the others that have been out there working so hard. Thank you very, very, very much. Also, we are going to be continuing to change the locks beginning this next Monday at the front of the church. It's a way that we can improve our own security here. Please refer to the e-blast for more information about how you can gain entrance after office hours. And now, a little bit of an update on the upcoming week. Ladies Chat Night tonight at 7 o'clock with me. It's a great time to come and connect with other women of the church, just to hang out for a little bit to find out how everybody's doing. The invite is in the e-blast on Wednesdays. Then Sunday morning, our worship service is posted by 9 a.m. Join with us as we worship God, as we sing praises, just enjoy worshiping together. The sermon this week is one entitled The Encourager, Engaging in Our Spiritual Gifts. Then the two the Christian formation classes, we only have one right now for the rest of August, and that is Darren. That will be at 11 o'clock. Jessica is taking a little bit of a break until September. Also, the Cafe Carlson will be closed for 2 weeks while Craig and Carolyn take a much-needed break, a vacation. Then next week, we'll have the prayer update Monday or Tuesday. Abby Chandler, I'm delighted, is going to be bringing our devotion this week, so check it out on our website. Also, the contents of all of this, all of our updates and devotions and worship services are mailed to those that do not have internet connection. Our e-blast, as always, will go out on Wednesday, and it provides many, many other opportunities for you to connect with one another, including the prayer Zoom prayer meeting on Wednesday at 6 and the Bible study by Zoom at 6:30. Then again, Thursday, 13th, church is going to be closed so that they can do the repairs that are needed. And Friday, check back and we'll have another update for you to tell you what's happening the following week. I hope that all is well for you and that you do continue to be safe, that you continue to be healthy, that you are getting a little bit of rest in there as well. Pray along with us that God will give wisdom to our governor and to all of those that are continuing to deal with this pandemic of how we best proceed. Especially pray for the school officials, for teachers, for parents, as they make those decisions about what to do and how best to open up safely in the fall. Now, God bless you, and may you be encouraged, because nothing can separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. God bless. Have a great day.